Shalom Aleichem and blessings of good health to all my dear listeners of this video. We all feel bad that we are being deprived of the beautiful tefillot and especially the precious shiurim which you listen to throughout the week. But there is a great mitzvah that overrides all the other mitzvot and which we must support and adhere to. That is, v'nishmartem me'od l'nafshotechem. We are commanded to be very careful to keep ourselves healthy and not take any chances to become, God forbid, sick. The vast majority of the poskim are recommending the same, mainly that we must conform and obey the instructions that the government experts are telling us in order to stay healthy and keep away from the devastating coronavirus. Still, in order to accommodate our members, we decided at least to record some short videos so that you can have a chance to continue Torah study. At present, your mind and the mind of most of the world is preoccupied with the horrible coronavirus, which has been plaguing the world for a while. Is there any lesson we can learn from this virus? I believe there are two lessons we can learn from here, one for the Goyim and one for us. Where did the coronavirus originate? It started in the marketplaces of China, where people eat raw food, live food, creepy and crawly creatures like the bat and the snake. Unfortunately, although it is unpleasant to speak about this, but the Chinese, who are also pure of the Avodah Zarah, worshipping idols, they tear pieces from live animals and eat it, thus violating the commandment of prohibiting eating ebe min ha'chai. The Torah commands us not to tear off a piece from a live animal in order to eat it. This command is not only for us. It is also one of the seven mitzvot which the Goyim must observe. The Chinese don't care. And Hashem brought this magifa on them. As a matter of fact, the Hebrew words, achal eber min ha'chai, he ate a limb from a live animal. These Hebrew words have a numerical value of 367, which is the same as corona when spelled with two vowels. Very interesting. Also, there is a Tosefta that says, Atida Kadosh Baruch Hu Lehabi Mabul Al Olam. In the future, in the days of the Mashiach, the Borei Olam will bring a Mabul, a deluge, on the Goyim. And Rabbi Yosef says, not a Mabul of water, a Mabul of Deber, a plague like the virus plague which will devastate the Goyim. Yes, in the days of the Mashiach, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will hit the Goyim, perhaps to force them to recognize the real God of the world. These plagues will be mainly for the Goyim, not the Jews, which explains why, even though there are many cases of coronavirus in Israel, the mortality rate is close to zero. Actually, the numerical value of corona with one vav is 361, which is equivalent to Mashiach Ba. Yes, Rabotai. These may be the days prior to the coming of the Mashiach. This is what we call Hevle Mashiach, the pain and suffering before the advent of the Mashiach. Rabotai, the holiday of Pesach is coming. And just as we will be reading the Haggadah I will be reading about the powerful blows that the Ten Makot Hashem brought upon the Egyptians while sparing the Bnei Israel from all danger. Many reasons for that. But one good reason also is to strengthen the Emunah of the Bnei Israel and to reinforce the Bitachon in the Borei Olam so as to accept his mitzvot with eagerness and joy. This is another lesson for us to see the immense power of the Almighty, who can throw the entire world into chaos, cause a large amount of sickness among other peoples, in order to have us, give us a great hizuk of emunah in the Borei Olam, to observe his mitzvot, and always keep the hope of the speedy coming of our Mashiach Tzidkenu. Amen.